God is just so awesome. Can we just start by just giving God praise right where we are? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Just begin to just open up your mouths and just begin to bless Him. Father, we thank You. We praise You. We lift You up even now. Glory to Your name, Jesus. What an amazing God You are. What an incredible God You are. What an awesome God You are. Woo. Father, there's no one like You. There's no one greater than You. There's no one stronger than You. There's no one wiser than You. There's no one better than You. Father, You sit on the throne and You sit alone, and we take this time to proclaim Your awesomeness, proclaim Your goodness. We're ready to just go for it and just let God have His way. I'm just so honored to be here in your great city, in this great church, to be able to worship with you all and the angels of this house. And to my leaders who aren't here, in their absence, I honor them. And all of you in your respective places, but most of all, we've come to honor Jesus. I mean, He's the reason why we're here on tonight. He's the reason why we've gathered here. The reason why we've come from the north, the south, the east, and the west. We've come to give God glory. We've come to lift up His name. Vertical. This is something that God gave me. And basically the objective is this. When I think of horizontal, I think of everything that's here that represents pretty much me, that just stays right here on this level. But when I think about vertical, I think about everything upward. Directing everything upwards. To be able to basically make this moment all about Jesus. Because I know that once I make everything about God, then He'll turn around and make everything about me. He'll take care of me. He'll handle whatever I may have brought in with me. I cast all my cares on Him. I give it to Him, and He'll take care of it. All He wants is for me to send up my praise, to send up my worship, and to pray. In Acts chapter 2, and this is where I got this from, well, part of it, basically when they were all in one place, this is the place, and they were with one accord, that means everybody was on the same page, everyone had the same understanding, the Spirit of God moved and it came in that place and it swept through like a mighty rushing wind. And they were all filled with the Holy Spirit at that moment. This is the place. This is the place. And we've all gathered here. We have the same understanding, the same agenda, and that is Jesus. So therefore, I believe that just as God demonstrated back then, He's going to demonstrate even on tonight. And whatever it is that you may have come in here, whatever burdens or anything that you may have been weighed down with, I dare you from that and to focus on Jesus. To focus on that name. That name is the name that saves, it heals, it sets free, it delivers, it breaks the chains. Yeah, that name. We're going to call on that name. We're going to pray. And I want you to be free on tonight. This is nothing sedity. This is a moment for you all to be free. You need to cry. You need to lay across this altar. Whatever it is that you need to do, be free to do so. Be free to do so. Be free. Be free. Be free. And when they pray, we're all praying together. We're all going to open up our mouths. Why? The Spirit of God is already here. The Spirit of God is already here. And although we're standing here, we're just making you aware of His nearness. God is here. He's already here. And He's going to do what He's going to do on tonight. I can feel it. I can feel it in the atmosphere. The presence of the Lord is here. And so we're going to pray. I'm going to have a minister, Latanya Fisk, come. And she's going to open up with a prayer. And we just want God to have His way on tonight. Is that all right? We want God to have His way on tonight.
People of God, lift your voices in this place. Open up your mouths. And let's just cry out to God on tonight. Lift your hands in this place. Hallelujah. Let's just invoke His presence on tonight. God, you are awesome. You dwell with them on tonight. God, you are awesome. God, we magnify your name. God, we glorify your name. God, you are awesome, and there is none like you, Father. There is none besides you, Father. You are God and God all by yourself. There is none like you, Father, in the heavens or in the earth, Father. And that's why we give your name the praise on tonight.
Over, over, over this place. place and then say, sing if it's not pleasing.
To your reluctance.
if it's not pleasing,
if it's not pleasing to you,
check it out.
Check it out, me.
If it's not pleasing to you,
if it's not pleasing to
check
you,
it out.
Check it out, me.
Have
your way.
Whatever you're dealing with, suicidal thoughts, depression, tell them if it's not pleasing,
if it's not pleasing to you,
check it out, me.
Check it out, me.
Doubt. If it's not pleasing to you,
it's not pleasing to you,
check it out of me.
Check it out of me.
If it's not pleasing to you,
if it's not pleasing to you,
take it out of me.
Take it out of me.
Have your
way.
Yeah.
your glory, your glory.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Show us your glory. Show us your glory. Show us your glory. We desire your glory. We desire your glory.
We cannot explain it.
Thank you.
thanksgiving, thanking you, God, for all you've done. Thanking you for who you are and what you want to do.
Hallelujah. His word says that better is one day in his courts than a thousand elsewhere. See, it's not about the amount of days. It's the quality. The Holy Spirit, he makes good use of his time. And we're in his presence. He comes to do business in our lives and in our hearts. We come, we're shifting gears to praise and thanksgiving. He says, I will enter his gates with thanksgiving. I will enter his courts with praise. Father God, we worship you because we are fearfully and wonderfully created. Marvelous are your works, and we know that full well. Father, we worship you and we declare your praises will be on our lips. You are a God who never fails. You have never left us or forsaken us. For that we give you praise. For that we worship you. For your Son came and died and shed his blood that we might have a way. You have bridged the gap, oh God. For that we give you praise. We thank you that you are a God who makes a way where it seems to be no way in our lives. We thank you that you are the source, that we put our trust and hope in you. We lift our eyes to the hills. From where comes our help? Your word says our help comes from you, O God, maker of heaven and earth. We worship you that you are a chain breaker, that God, you have broken the chains off our lives and off our hearts. You are a hope giver. We thank you for that, God, that you give us hope in a hopeless world. We are worshiping Almighty God. We are worshiping Almighty God. We are worshiping our Savior and King. We give you praise that you are life, that you are hope, that you are our peace, that you are our strength, that you are our maker, that you are our Savior, that you are our life. We worship you. We worship you. We worship you, God. We worship you, God. We give you the glory in this place. We thank you that, God, your mercies are new every morning. We cry out for new mercies right now. We cry out for new mercies. We thank you, God. We thank you, God. We give you the praise. We move past the outer courts into your presence by lifting up the name of Jesus. When the praises go up, your word says, the blessings come down in this house and in our lives. For that we give you praise. We thank you, God, that you are our healer, that you are our hope, you are our giver. We thank you, God, that your love never fails. Thank you, Jesus, that you pull us from the gutter to the uttermost. You bring us out, God. We worship you for that. We thank you, God, that your presence is among us tonight. We worship you, that your anointing is fresh and new right now in this place. Whatever we have need of, you are the provider. When we need that inner peace, you are running to our side. That you're close to the brokenhearted. Even now, as we lift up our cry to you, God, you are coming to our rescue in this house tonight. We worship you, Holy Spirit. We thank you. We thank you. That our weapons are not carnal, but they're mighty through God, through the tearing down of strongholds. And we lift up the name of Jesus, for it is in the name of Jesus, the name above all names. Almighty God, we worship you. We thank you. We praise you, Father. We worship you, God. Hallelujah, hallelujah. We enter your gates. We enter your courts. We're moving past, God. We want more. We want more. In the name of Jesus.
Come on, would you just begin to stir the atmosphere in this place? The Lord dropped a word inside my heart, and I believe it's for 2018. I believe it's for the pastor, for this house, and for each and every one of you. And the Lord would say, no more delays. The Lord would say, no more delays. You've already stepped out. You are already going, but it's time for there to be no more delays. For the artists and worship leaders that are on this platform, the Lord is saying, no more delays. No more delays. No more delays. It's time. It's time. It's time. Come on, people of God, would you begin to release that word inside? inside of you, would you begin to lift up the name that's higher than every name? The name of Jesus, the everlasting God, the strong tower. God, we love you and we thank you, Jesus. Well, let's sing.
The Lord is my light and salvation. Whom shall I fear? Whom shall I be afraid? The Lord is my light and salvation.
Sometimes it's hard to wait on God, but I will wait, Jesus, on you. And God,
I will trust in you. I will trust in you.
Yeah, come on, let's sing the Lord.
The Lord is my light.
Hey,
salvation.
Whom shall I fear?
Whom shall I fear?
Yeah.
Whom shall I fear?
Trust in you today.
I will trust in you.
I will trust in you.
I will trust in you.
up and tell him, I will confident in
hey.
I will see you, Jesus.
I will remain confident in this. I will see the goodness of the Lord. He will see the goodness of the Lord. He will see the goodness of the Lord. We will see the goodness of the Lord. So we will remain confident in this. We'll see the goodness of the Lord. I will remain confident in this. We'll see the goodness of the Lord.
Let's go to the other part, to the one.
We set our hopes on you. We set our hopes on you.
Yeah.
We set our hopes on the one who is the everlasting God.
Yeah.
You are the everlasting God.
Come on, say, we set our hopes on you. Come on, say.
We set our hopes on you. We set our hopes on your love. We set our hopes on the one.
Joyful song.
Yeah.
oh sovereign one, Lord,
Oh,
When our backs were
Yes, we're standing here only because you made a way. Don't know how, but you did it. You made a way. Don't know how, but you did it.
If you remember where you were, you were sinking in your sin. You deserve death, hell, and the grave. But the blood of Jesus, the blood of Jesus, covered you in your sin and pulled you out of the pit of hell. Thank you, Jesus. There ought to be a grateful people in the house. Full of praise and worship comes from your lips. Like a stream to sing you.
You've been good.
Where did my star go?
You've been good.
Every time I get one away.
want to take this time to begin to just, this is one of the most important times to me. And Pastor Kevin, Pastor Lisa, they're going to come. They're going to pray. This is a time, an altar call, however pastor is led to do, we'll follow that. But I feel that it is very imperative for those of you who says, I need to come to the altar. I may need personal prayer. I don't know how you guys do it here in this house, but however you see fit, pastor, this is the time for you to come, invite the people to the altar and pray. And so at this time, I'm going to yield it over to you.
Glory to God. Every hand lifted all over the room. If you're here tonight and you poured your heart out in worship and you're saying, you know what? I really, really, really could use something to push me to the next place. Tonight has been a very pivotal night for many of us in this room. And if you know that she prayed earlier about the spirit of faith and that faith just waning down in your soul, and you need an extra push tonight in worship, I want you to come to the altar very quickly. Just move. You know how we do in this house. Just move quickly, move quickly, move quickly. Just come out of your seats. Come very quickly. We want to agree with you tonight. Glory to God. Glory to God. If you're looking at breakthrough and you're just about there, but you're not fully there tonight, I want you to come. I want you to come just quickly. Father, I need a touch from the Spirit of God. I need something to move my family to the next place. Come with your hands extended towards the heavens tonight. We're just going to believe God with you as you come in. Come on, preachers, if you would just position yourselves very quickly. There's no hocus pocus on tonight, but we just believe God to do something amazing. Come with your hands up as your heart is crying out. I need those who know to pray just begin to pray in the Holy Ghost. Y'all know what we do. Come on, begin to lift up your voices. Glory to God. He's worthy. Hey. We're praying for strength tonight. Hey, that the heavens will open over your family, over all that you need, over your bodies, over your health, over your mental capacity in this holiday season. Come on, lift it. Preachers, I want you to begin to lay your hands on their shoulders. Just begin to impart strength in the house tonight. Begin to impart strength. You can come alongside. Come on. Well, Father, in Jesus' name, we pray for your strength and your peace in this holiday season. You know exactly what the needs are of your children. You know exactly where they are hurting, where they're facing difficulties now. We just release your strength. We release your strength. We release your presence now. We release your presence and your glory to come to them even now in Jesus' name. Come on, lift up your voices now. Hey. Even in this worship experience, hey, we thank you for an open heaven now. Release the heaven to them. Release the comfort to them even now. In the name of the Lord Jesus, the Son of God. Come on. We release your strength, and now we push back every demonic scheme and every entity, every scandal and every ploy and every demonic power that seeks to steal your peace in the season of your life. And we decree and we declare, hey, that this shall be a fresh season of fire, a fresh season of the anointing, a fresh season of focus to you now. We rebuke every scheme and every ploy and every demonic power released from the spirit of darkness to seek after your peace, to disturb your family, to disturb your mental capacity. And we release the glory of God to consume every enemy of your soul. We decree and declare that the scheme against your family, the scheme against your mind, the scheme against your relationship, the scheme in your body shall be canceled now. And we decree and declare heaven's best, heaven's future over you now. Come on, church, with the voices. We decree and declare that this shall be your finest season. That in the next few moments, the next few days of this year, that God shall accelerate to you and shall bring back to you what take your words and love.
freedom in this place. We thank you for deliverance, Ani and I'm Calamos. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, God, that we're free. We're free. We're free. We're free. We're free.
We thank you.
3 is what? There's a beautiful song. I'm not going to preach here, I promise. But there's a beautiful song that says, for there's power in the name of Jesus to break every chain. How many believe that in the place tonight? How many believe there's power in the name of Jesus to break chains, to destroy your channel? Don't sound like it. How many believe that there's power in the name of Jesus to break chains? Listen, what I want to add to that beautiful song, break it all the way down for me, is that the chains that we're talking about breaking in Jesus' name, those chains were broken at Calvary. The very chains, the very bondage that we're talking about in that song, those chains were broken when he said, it is finished. When he rose with all power, when he said, death, where's your sting? Great, where's your victory? When he rose with all power, he rose with the power of those chains that we're singing about. So now, as believers, all we have to do is walk into the freedom that's been paid for by the blood of the cross. As believers on Christ Jesus, freedom has been bought for you already. All you have to do is choose freedom. The Bible says, I place before you life and death. Choose life. So now, when somebody look at you the wrong way, or somebody cut you off, or somebody slide in your DMs, oh, y'all ain't gonna talk back to me, y'all gonna be real tonight, or somebody send you that late night snack, come on y'all, you have a choice to make, to either be bound to your former self, or to be free in Jesus Christ. How many free people I got in the building tonight? I said, how many free people I got in the building tonight? Who's going to choose to be free from this moment on? From this night on, I choose to be free. I make my decision right here, right now, in the presence of the Lord.
To be free. Just keep those hands lifted. Keep them lifted in His presence. His presence is here. His glory is in this house. God, we come before you tonight. Thank you for liberation. Thank you, God, for setting us free. God, in every aspect of our lives. Thank you for deliverance. Oh, God, Abasha. Thanks be unto God. God, because you always cause us to triumph. And God, we stand to give you praise tonight for breaking every shackle, for destroying every chain, God. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, God, somebody came in bound, but God, they're leaving out free. Somebody, God, came in suicidal, ready to give up. But God, because of your blood and because of your presence, God, you set free in this house tonight. And God, we give you praise right now.